यस ओके
ओके आई एम रेडी।
ओके ओके मैम थैंक यू। गुड इवनिंग एवरी वन। स्वामी विवेकानंदा सेज इफ एजुकेशन इज आइडेंटिकल विद इंफॉर्मेशन द लाइब्रेरीज आर द ग्रेटेस्ट सेजेस इन द वर्ल्ड एंड एनसाइक्लोपीडियाज आर द ऋषिज। I hope this session will make us to get more information for our thirst of knowledge. I am wholeheartedly welcome you to this fourth day of International Virtual Faculty Development Program on the topic of outcome-based curriculum on behalf of Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University, Department of Curriculum Planning and Evaluation and the Department of Educational Technology, Bharathidasan University. First, I would like to thank our and a warm welcome our Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University Vice Chancellor sir, and warm welcome our Bharathidasan University Vice Chancellor sir. Next, in turn, I would like to thank and welcome Registrar of Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University and Registrar of Bharathidasan University, and also our heartfelt thanks and welcome Professor and Head Department of Educational Technology, Bharathidasan University. Excuse me. Next in turn, with the immense pleasure and joy, I welcome all the participants of this international virtual program who played an important role in this program. Welcome, dear participants. I extend my sincere thanks and cordially welcome an eminent resource person. It is the right time to introduce the resource person. Excuse me. Yes, Dr. Sunita Mithunrao Magre, ma'am, professor and director in charge, Department of Education, University of Mumbai. Ma'am has acted as the many statutory authority in important responsibility, such as Vice President of National Child and Women Development Council, Maharashtra State, member of BOS in Education, Mahatma Gandhi Antarashtriya Hindi Vishwavidyalaya Central University Vartha, member of Court Central University of Karnataka, chairperson of BOSE University of Mumbai. She has acted as a research guide in University of Mumbai. She has guided 20 PhD degree students and 16 MPhil degree students awarded and completed two projects funded by UGC and Maharashtra State Commission for Women, postdoctoral fellowship going on for the two students. Editor Sansothan Chatna UGC approved journal. She has 25 years teaching experience. She has 35 invited talk at state and national seminars, conference, workshops and symposium. She has published 7 books, 6 edited conference proceedings and 8 editorial desk, 12 edited self-study materials and 10 translated of the self-study material, 110 paper published. Ma'am has received many awards such as Professor Indra Parikh Award for 50 Women in Education Leaders in Asia at the World Education Congress on Sustainable Development Goals, Quality Education for All on 5th July 2018. Next, President of Marathi Shikshan Sastra Paripaksha course given by Government of Maharashtra. Ma'am have so many awards and honor. So I conclude my introductory speech and hand over this session to ma'am. Please, ma'am. सुनीता मैम अनम्यूट यूरसेल्फ।
हेलो
यस मैम।
एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस मैम यस मैम।
सो शैल आई स्टार्ट द सेशन?
यस मैम यस मैम।
सो आई शेयर द माय स्क्रीन फर्स्ट।
ओके मैम प्लीज अनम्यूट योर माइक्रोफोन मैम। ओके मैम।
या सो वेलकम ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स इन 5A इंटरनेशनल वर्चुअल फैकल्टी डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम ऑन आउटकम बेस्ड करिकुलम एंड थैंक यू फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी फॉर दिस 5 days इंटरनेशनल वर्चुअल।
मैम
I think
ma'am, your voice is not audible.
No, she has lost her connection.
Okay.
What is curriculum and what is the syllabus, and then when we develop the curriculum, any type of the curriculum, we have some strong basic foundation for the curriculum development. So what are that basic foundation of curriculum development? So in detail we have to study it. So the first thing is, what is curriculum? My first question is, what is curriculum? And second question is, what is syllabus? See, the curriculum and syllabus, these are the two terminology. Both the terminology some people use as the same way, but there is a difference between the syllabus and the curriculum. See this picture. There are the three circle, and at the end, the three circle meet at the end. Now, teaching program is one of the circle. Syllabus is second circle, and the curriculum is the third circle. Now, the teaching program. For example, take any one of the teaching program. It is B.Ed. or M.Ed. or M.B.A. B.A. M.A. in Marathi, Hindi, Tamil, Telugu, Tamil, whatever it is. It's any of the teaching program you have to check. And we go to the second circle, that is the syllabus. Now, for example, teaching program, I am from the education faculty, so I am taking as a B.Ed. is a teaching program, or M.Ed. is a teaching program. Now, syllabus, so, and the curriculum. What is the curriculum of B.Ed.? In the curriculum, suppose in your B.Ed. program, there are the many subjects. Some are the core courses, some are audit courses, some are elective courses, some are special courses, whatever it is. So we have to take all the courses in one of the curriculum. Now, in the curriculum, there is the list of the subject. It is one of the part. In the curriculum, there is the structure of the curriculum. Means your curriculum is 1 year or 2 year or 3 year, 4 year, 5 year integrated courses are there, or curriculum of primary education, curriculum of secondary education, curriculum of tertiary education, like that. So this is the curriculum, and in that curriculum syllabus is there. In that curriculum syllabus is there. So what is that syllabus? So little bit we'll discuss later. First we will clarify the curriculum. Now in these curriculum I have given the list of the courses. Now in the curriculum there is a examination pattern. So which pattern you have to follow? Some of the universities follows CBCS pattern, that is the credit based choice system. Some of the curriculum university follows CBS GS, that is credit based choice grading system. Some are yearly pattern. For example, Mumbai University of Mumbai followed the CBCS pattern, that is the choice based system. So CBCS pattern, choice based credit system. Now in this pattern, for BEd program, that is the teaching program BEd, in BEd there are the 2 year program, and in that 2 year there are the 4 semesters. So all should be included in that curriculum. BEd program, then 2 year program, then 4 semesters, and each semester having the previous subject. So what that subject?
Ma'am, hello, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. But unnecessary voices here, ma'am.
Now in the curriculum, and we come to the syllabus. So, for example, semester one, and there are the core courses. Suppose there are the 4 core courses. For example, BEd. Knowledge and curriculum, it is one of the subject. Peace education, it is one of the subject. So knowledge and curriculum. So in knowledge and curriculum, this is the subject, and according to this subject, there is a syllabus. So syllabus of this subject. So syllabus is the part of curriculum. So curriculum is the bigger umbrella, and syllabus is the one more petal of the curriculum. So in the curriculum there are the various petals, and the curriculum is the umbrella. So this, I think it is clear what is curriculum and what is syllabus. It is very simple. Take another example. For example, MSc, or take any one of the engineering syllabus. So in the engineering syllabus, that it's a 4 year course, and that 4 years course is comes under the curriculum of the engineering, that is BE part 1. It ends of 4 years, 8 semesters or yearly pattern, whatever, all should include in that curriculum. And one of the subjects, mechanical engineering, it is one of the subject, that is the syllabus. And in that subject, so there are the various units. Now suppose we take one of the subject. So in one subject, what is your pattern? That is suppose CBCS pattern. And in that pattern, we have to take the modules. Suppose we take 2 modules, and in that 2 modules, we take 3 units. Okay. And in that 3 unit, we have to take again 3 subunits. Means each module, what are the credit of each module, how many hours of that each module, and in that module there are the 3 units, A, B, C, whatever it is, and each unit having 3 subunits or 4 subunits or 5 subunits according to the your university pattern. So this is known as the syllabus. Now let us come to the when we develop any kind of this curriculum, we have some of the foundation, basic foundation of the curriculum. So our curriculum is depend upon that basic foundation. So what are that basic foundation? So I conclude curriculum and syllabus. So curriculum is a comprehensive overview of what students should learn, how they will learn, what is the role of instructor. Instructor is playing and the framework in which learning and teaching will take place. Another say, the curriculum is a total guided learning experiences designed to facilitate learners' learning for establishing quality relationship between what is learned and what operates outside the school. Shortly, we can conclude that curriculum includes aims, objectives, teaching content, teaching strategies, assessment methods, and other components of learning and teaching in the classroom. Means what are the rules, regulation, norms about the examination? It is also included in the. So this is about the curriculum. So what are the foundation of our curriculum? Let's take the basic foundation of the curriculum development. Now, foundation are the forces that influence the minds of the curriculum developers. It affects the content and the structure of the curriculum. The curriculum reflects the society and culture of a country, and it is the desire of the society that their children should learn their habits, ideas, attitudes, and skills of the society and the culture, and educational institutions are proper way to impart all these skills. The duty of the teacher and the university and the school is to discipline the young children of the society and provide them with a set of experiences in the form of curriculum. The needs, knowledge, and information of the society provide foundation in the formation of the. So there are. Five foundation, philosophical foundation, sociological foundation, psychological foundation, economical foundation, and historical foundation. So there are the five foundation of the curriculum development. Let's take one by one. So philosophical foundation of curriculum, the educators, curriculum developers, the teachers have espoused a philosophy or philosophy that are deemed necessary for planning, implementing, and evaluating the curriculum. The philosophy, whenever you develop the curriculum, any type of the curriculum, we have some of the philosophical basis. So what are that basis? The philosophy that they have embraced will help them define the purpose of the school or the university or the college, the important subject to be taught, the kind of learning students must have, and how they can acquire them, the instructional material, the various methods, the various strategies to be used, and how students will be evaluated. So this philosophy offers the solution of the problem and to help how to solve that problem and how to help the administrators teacher educators, curriculum developers, curriculum planners, and the teachers for taking some decision. There are very important schools related in the philosophical foundation of curriculum development: the idealism, realism, fragmentism, and existentialism. So before going to this syllabus or schools, so we can take one of the important topic. Curriculum is a dynamic side of philosophy. Philosophy searches not a simple truth, but it is the eternal truth. It means it find out the reality as well as the general principle of the life. The curriculum help in the practical use of knowledge. Where to use this practical use of knowledge? In the real life situations, in day-to-day life situations, and understanding the realities as well as what are the ideas of the life. Then according to that ideas of the life, we can use the knowledge. Curriculum is used for the modification of the behavior of the student, and philosophy help in the process of finding new ways and basis for teachers and curriculum planners to modify their behaviors.
Ma'am, excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, Sunita, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, sometimes unnecessary noises from your side, ma'am.
Unnecessary noise. Just I will check it. Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Philosophy also helps in the exploring new methods according to the need of the learner. We want to implement the new methods of teaching and how to apply that new methods in the classroom situation for the teaching learning process, and how to evaluate this teaching learning process. Philosophy and ideology has the direct effect in the curriculum planning. Now come to that four isms. What are that isms? The idealism, realism, pragmatism, and existentialism. So these four educational philosophies are important in the curriculum development. Now in idealism, what is the aim of education in idealism? Is to discover and develop the each individual abilities and full moral excellence in order to better serve society. While developing curriculum, idealists give more importance to thoughts, feelings, ideas, and values rather than the children's activities. Means they give more importance on the feelings of the learner. The thoughts of the levels. Udayam Udayam. Thoughts of the learners. And the idealism give the specific role to the teacher. It consider teacher as a spiritual guide for the child. He or she sets the environment in which education takes place. He or she carries the child from darkness to the light. He is to guide the student towards possible perfection. An idealist teacher, the philosopher, friend, and the guide. According to the proverb, school is a garden and the teacher is a gardener. And the child is a tender plant. See, there are the three concepts according to the proverb. Now the school is a garden. So let us take as a garden. Okay. And teacher is a gardener. Means the important role in the garden is a gardener is the important. So the teacher having the important role in the garden. And child, there are the small plants. And how that small plants is developed. What is the duty and responsibility? So which activities are important for development of the student? So that activities done by the teacher in the idealistic perspective. Plant can grow, no doubt, but without help of the good gardener, it is not developed properly. Like the same way students are grow, definitely they will grow, but through the guidance of the teacher, they develop very well. Their personality is well developed. Their behavior is well developed. So this is the idealistic role of the idealistic teacher. Now, take the realism or the realistic curriculum. So what is realism and what is the realistic curriculum? Realistic curriculum, it is focused on experience. The experience is important in the realism. Realism is based on the reason and the science. What is the reason? And for that reason, what is the science? It is important. So reason and the science is important in the realistic perspective. Realism represent theory that particular things exist independently of our perception. Then realist curriculum wanted to include those subjects and the activities which would prepare the children for actual day-to-day life, day-to-day living, day-to-day life experience. Realistic curriculum gave the primary place or the important place is to nature, then science, and the vocational subject. Whereas secondary place is for arts, literature, biography, philosophy, psychology, and the morality. Realistic curriculum also stress upon the teaching of mother. They give importance. The teaching language is always a mother tongue. Then role of the teacher, according to the realism, the teacher must be a scholar and his duty is to guide the students for the hardcore life realities of their life. He or she must expose them to the problems of life. The teacher should have full knowledge of the content and needs of the children. He or she must be aware what is the need of the children. Then according to the need of the children, he or she will provide information as well as the knowledge. The teacher should inspire the child to undertake close observation and experimentation for finding out new facts and the principles. Next one is the pragmatism. Pragmatism, the focus of the pragmatism is on the reality of the experiences. Pragmatists believe the reality is constantly changing and we learn based through applying our experiences and thoughts to the problem and they raise. The aim of the education, according to the pragmatism, is to provide dynamic direction and guidance to the child according to his natural interest, aptitude, and capacity in the field of academic activities, that he or she grows up and develops more and is endowed with capacities to confront the ever-changing problems and challenges. Any problem? My voice is clear now?
Yes, ma'am. Your voice is clear.
So, according to the pragmatism, how they give more importance to the experiences. And for this education, should develop such a dynamic, flexible, an adaptable mind, which is always resourceful and enterprising and is able to create new values according to the situation, according to the experiences, for the future, unknown future, because it is presently coming through the experiences. The curriculum must grow out children's interest, their experiences, their impulses, and their pragmatism, the curriculum should be child-centered. They stress, pragmatists stress, the school subject should be woven around the children's activities. The curriculum should be flexible, useful, experimental, and life related. Then, according to the pragmatist, role of teacher is always a friend, philosopher, and guide to the student. He or she should have the capacity to know what is the interest of their student. What is the interest of the learner? Teachers should understand the condition and the situation of changing the society. When he have the awareness and he have the capacity and he understand various situation according to the society and the needs of the learners, so according to that, he or she will implement the curriculum. The next one is the existentialism. Now, existentialism, this is the fourth school of curriculum development. Existentialism is the philosophy concerned with the finding self and the meaning of life through free will, choice, and personal responsibilities. An existentialist curriculum will consist of experiences and subjects that lay themselves to philosophical dialogue and acts as a choice making, because the choice is personal and the subject. The curriculum, the existentialist curriculum, it is composed of fine arts, drama, creative expression, literature, and philosophy. Occasional education also important in the existentialism curriculum. And this existentialist curriculum, it is include self-expressing activities, experimentation, various methods and media that illustrate emotional feelings and the insight. So this is about the philosophical foundation of curriculum development. In this philosophical formation, the four schools are play a very, very important role. It is idealistic curriculum, realistic curriculum, pragmatist curriculum, and the existentialist curriculum. Now, come to the next foundation, that is the sociological foundation of curriculum. This foundation is very, very important, because through this foundation, what is the actual position or what is the actual culture of that society, of that nation, will be exposed. So, sociological foundation, the purpose of the curriculum planner and developers to translate traditional norms, philosophies, ethics, knowledge, and attitude in the objective of the curriculum. The content, learning process, and the evaluation of the elements, the curriculum. Sociological factors have very high impact on the content of the curriculum. And that is the reason that curriculum developers and the planners both reflect and transfer their own culture in the curriculum. Therefore, a curriculum without the reflection of culture is not possible. For the reason, one should consider what characteristics of the culture should be the part of curriculum. Then societal goals and the societal needs. The goal of education emerges the needs and the wishes of the society. Wishes of the society. When the society urge a need or goal, it becomes the educational objective. And school accepted the demand and they attain that goal. They put it into your curriculum objective. When the societal goal become an educational objective, then the school or college or university, the teacher and the learner must take their efforts to achieve it. and for the purpose of appropriate educational facilities and methods will be planned. Then educational aims are based on the study of sociological as well as the political condition of the society. And the main purpose of the curriculum is preservation and advancement of the society. I will give one of the example for the sociological foundation of curriculum development. In a school curriculum, just take the primary education, secondary education or tertiary education. In our school curriculum, there is no place about our constitution, Constitution of India. And in this pandemic situation, it is very important to need or to provide the awareness about the Constitution of India. So this is the, at present, this is the need. Means to student should know what are their rights, what are their duties, what are their responsibilities. If we include the Constitution of rights, some little parts from primary to the PG. So according to my knowledge, every individual should be aware about the Constitution of India, that is our rights, our duties, and our responsibility. According to the Millennium Development Goal, so global citizenship education, so for the global citizenship education, everybody knows their rights about their health, about their education, about their right to education. So the individual should be aware what are their rights. So this is the important part of the sociological foundation of the. That's why the curriculum in the sociological foundation, the curriculum should be constructed in accordance with the needs, requirements, conditions, and the aspiration of the society, so that qualities of sociability and citizenship are inculcated in each child, in each individual. Curriculum should prepare students for the world of tomorrows by providing them the knowledge and the values they need to make wise decisions. Curriculum should be constructed according to the needs, requirements, and the condition of the society. So this is about the sociological foundation of curriculum. Now comes to the psychological foundation of the curriculum. As a fraternity of a teacher, we know the psychology is very, very important, play a very, very important part in the development of the curriculum. So curriculum, according to the psychological foundation, curriculum should be flexible to meet the individual needs of the children and allow each child to develop his natural part and progress at his own speed. For this, curriculum should include games when we want the natural growth of our child. So definitely we will include the games, sports, and the creative activities in our curriculum. Children are developing various stages, and there have individual differences are there. The individual differences of interest, their needs, capabilities, abilities. So psychological foundation emphasizes that education is for the child. Education is for the child, not that child for education. So education is for the child, not child for the education. The stress on this end. Child is the center of educational process, or the in the education process, child is the center according to the psychological formation. Now in the psychology, there are the two schools. I hear they write it down. It is the behaviorism and the cognitivism. So in the according to the behaviorism school, so learning is considered as habit formation, and teaching is regarded as arranging learning experiences in such as a way to promote desirable behavior. A curriculum according to the behaviorist should be remediation, skill acquisition, consideration of basic and the advanced learning, appropriate instructional material and the media to suit the learner's ability, that shape behavior through task, activities, close supervision and the positive reinforcement. So this is important in the behavioristic syllabus curriculum. Then according to the cognitivism, cognitivism focus their attention on how individual process information and how the monitor and manage thinking. For the cognitive theorist, learning constitutes a logical method for organizing and interpreting learning. Learning is rooted in the tradition of subject where teacher use a lot of problems and thinking skills in the teaching and learning process. Then historical foundation of curriculum. In the historical foundation, it starts from the Franklin Witt to the Ralph Taylor, and according to them, so in historical foundation, there is a focus, child center is the part of the historical foundation of the curriculum. Then end is the Ralph Taylor, and all these are focused. The natural setting is important in the historical foundation of education. Then economical foundation of the curriculum development. In there are the two part in the economical foundation. It focuses two important aspect. One is the job or market oriented curriculum, and another is the skill learning. The economical foundation of curriculum give importance to the vocational aspect of the curriculum. The economic condition of a nation or a society guide the curriculum of the country, because the stakeholder of the education wants to employ such a curriculum which help them to build their economy, and the people have better jobs when they finish their schooling. After they finish their schooling, definitely they will get the job. Economical in this type of the curriculum developer gives importance to the skill acquisition, and which is the demand of the child. Undeveloped nation try to prepare skilled workforce and send it to the other countries for the jobs. So economical factors influence the curriculum development process. So what are that economical factors? The first factor is the allocation of the funds. The financial condition of a country reflect its curriculum, because without proper funding, we cannot achieve the outcomes of a good country. It is the financial aspect of a country which guide them to adopt which type of the curriculum. For example, activity-based curriculum. When we implement the activity-based curriculum, definitely we have more finance for the activity-based curriculum. Because when we implement the activity-based curriculum, means we need to train the teacher, we need to organize more practical sessions, which needs to provide infrastructure for the learners. So these are the financial aspects. Second is the lack of skilled manpower. The lack of skilled manpower due to the financial restraints, without proper financial support, it is hard to train the people. Those who want to provide the training, those who want to give the training to the other people. So first we have to train them. So without proper financial support, it is hard to train the people to support the teaching learning process. Only through proper funding and the establishment of training institution for teachers and support staff. Teachers are the core of the education system. And without proper training of the teacher, we cannot implement the curriculum, and to support the curriculum, one needs to train the entire teacher on that style of the. So the skill of the teacher also guide the direction of the curriculum, and to develop these skills in the teacher needs funds. Next factor is lack of labs and the libraries. The lack of labs and the libraries also affect the curriculum development process, because without proper labs in the cities, villages, universities, educational institutions, we cannot implement the curriculum. For example, now in this pandemic situation, everybody goes through the online. But can we have the structure of this online platform? No, it is very difficult, because our country is not provide the technological support. How many students have the Android mobile? This is the first part. How many students to get the internet connectivity? Who will pay that internet connectivity? Who will pay for the Android mobile? Suppose in example, in one house, there are the four children are studying in one family. Means they want four Android mobile. It is possible in our country? According to my knowledge, it is very difficult. So this is the lack of labs and the lab. And without libraries, without referencing books, how we can implement the guide? So this is the lack of labs and the lab. Our next important is healthcare system. So without proper healthcare system in the school, lot of activities cannot part of the curriculum due to the risk factor to the health of the student as well as the teacher. See, take this pandemic situation. If our country or our state provide the healthcare system. Our school is sanitized. We have no space for providing the facilities. So healthcare is very, very important to implement or to develop the. Then population explosion. The overburden of the population is one of the factors that affect financial support of the curriculum development. Lack of facilities and implementation of the curriculum in the country. In our country, like India, in our classroom, having the capacity of student, we know that each class having 100 students, or in some school it is more than 100 students. Can we implement what is the ratio of the student and the teacher? Can we have the place of the children for the 6 feet? That social distancing or the physical distancing, can we maintain this physical distancing in the present situation? Can we have that type of the infrastructure in our school, in our university, in our educational institution? So this is the important factor for the curriculum development. So these are the economical factor for the curriculum development. Hello, madam. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
The time is over.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. 10 more minutes is enough for you, ma'am.
No, I will conclude this because this is my
last. Yes, ma'am. Yeah. Okay, ma'am. Okay. Conclude, ma'am. So, okay.
Yeah. If you have any question or any doubt, so I can discuss with the people.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
My topic is over.
Okay. Participants, dear participants, if you have any doubts, unmute yourself, ask your doubts. Yes, ma'am. Intro yourself.
My name is Tasneem Fatima. I want to know what are the socio-political factors that affect curriculum development.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Yes.
What is the question?
Repeat your question, ma'am.
Ma'am, what are socio-political factors that affect curriculum development?
So what are socio-curricular factors, socio-political factors?
Socio-political.
Yeah. So what is the need of the society? Now see the present situation, this pandemic situation. So we know the how to take the examination, right? Then from the March to the month of August, so 6 months we cannot take the decision of the when we are taking the examination or not. So students are suffering. So this is the important factor to develop the curriculum or implement the curriculum.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Next question.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Ask your question, sir.
Yes. The curriculum development is
the idealism and so realism and the excellentialism, the curriculum. How now the idealism is possible in classroom, the secondary level?
If teacher wants, so if it is possible. If teacher do not want it, so it is not possible. How it is? So according to in the idealistic curriculum, we have to more importance to the values. So there are the number of the ethical values. So through our curriculum, we can develop the more values through the idealistic curriculum.
But because if the idealism curriculum in classroom, some people they are related to religion.
Yeah.
That's why the teacher will not force to follow that the idealism in curriculum. Is it?
See correct? All the when you studied all the curriculum, no, idealistic, realistic, etc. So in all that curriculum, so humanity is the important factor. So humanity, yeah. You can implement the humanity. So you can implement the idealism, and the experiences is also important. So means when you humanity and the experiences, definitely you touch the feeling of the learners.
Okay. Thank you, madam. Thank you, madam. Very nicely for talking.
Hello, Dr. Sunita.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, madam. Thank you, madam.
Doctor, I have a question. How this curriculum fit into the overall framework of outcome-based education?
Yeah, it is fitted in the outcome-based education. So in our outcome-based education means what?
The entire structure, the entire curriculum, evaluation, assessment.
I will give one example, outcome-based education or outcome-based curriculum. For example, your B.Ed. curriculum. What is the objective of that outcome of this B.Ed. curriculum? You have to create the teachers or the good teachers. What it is? Suppose you have to create the teachers. Everybody gives the degree, they are the teacher. But what is the teacher's characteristics is different according to the person by person.
Okay.
So we can take this as an important fact.
Okay, madam, thank you.
Any other questions? Hello. Ah, yes, ma. Of your question, ma.
Ma'am, I would like to ask. Yeah, in one chat, I got one question. Which country has best curriculum? So this is the question. So I am an Indian. I know my curriculum is the my country's curriculum is the best curriculum. If you are American, so you can say my country curriculum is the best curriculum. So curriculum is depend upon how to implement the curriculum. That is the biggest thing. How you can implement.
Any other person? Yes, ma'am. Say loudly.
Good evening, ma'am.
Ma'am,
I have a question in psychology-based curriculum.
Mm.
You have been talking about the cognitivism and the behaviorism. But I have a doubt of considering the other aspects like the micro system and the macro system. Will these two be covered in this two aspects, madam?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, so in that sense, how this micro and macro will be covered, madam? Because we'll be talking from the biological perspective, sociological perspective, cognitive perspective, behavioristic perspective. So in this, how it is related or how it will be clubbed in these two aspects?
That psychological and the biological.
In psychological. Yeah.
See, itself, psychology and biology are very close subject.
Okay,
because the personality, the person from the biology and the, how to develop that person, it is the psychology. Got it?
Okay, okay, madam. Okay, thank you.
What is my need? So I give them my need. What is my need? And psychology provides that need.
Okay.
So that is the relation between psychological and the biological.
Okay, thank you, madam. Thank you.
I think Rajeshwari, it is okay.
Okay, ma'am. Shall we conclude the session, ma'am?
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. Your presentation is excellent and informative. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. Now I invite Dr. Amuta, ma'am, Assistant Professor, Department of Educational Technology, Bharathidasan University, to propose vote of thanks. Please, ma'am.
Happy evening to all. I feel delighted to propose vote of thanks for the fourth day of strategy development program. Madam Sumita has explored with her prolific ideas regarding character aspects. I thank her profusely. I would like to thank the Vice Chancellor, Registrars and Head of the Departments of both Bharathidasan and Teacher Education Universities for their cooperation and involvement. I also endorse Dr. Rajeshwari, one of the organizing secretaries of the FDP, for her collaboration. A very big applause to the participants for their active association in this FDP. Thank you, one and all. Have a great evening.
Thank you, ma'am. Sunita, ma'am, very, very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, do we have any feedback link today, ma'am?
Tomorrow, ma'am. Tomorrow you have feedback link.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Amuta, ma'am, shall we end the meeting?
Rajeshwari, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, please add my number from WhatsApp group.
Okay, ma'am. No problem. We add your number. Okay.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Yes.